Good morning, children. Welcome to Pranav International Online Classes. I am Sabita of your class Grade 6 Social Science Facilitator. Today I am going to teach you latitudes and longitudes. This is planet Earth. It is a delicately beautiful planet in an endless ocean of space and continents oceans. The Earth is our home and we all share the same home as one family. Planet Earth is the largest of the planet. It is made up of continents and oceans. The Earth is so big in size that it is difficult to tell the location of any place on the Earth, and so the Greek philosopher and mathematician Eratosthenes came up with latitudes and longitudes. Now the spinning of the Earth on its axis provides two naturally fixed points, and that is North Pole and South Pole. When you have glance at any globe, it will show a series of north and south and east and west, and together they create a grid system. It is also known as geographical grid. These lines are used to find the exact location of a place on the Earth. The north meridians of longitude, these lines are called, and the extent from the North Pole and to the South Pole, all these meridians are actually half circles. The east and west lines are known as parallels of latitudes. So what are latitudes? Latitudes is an angular distance of a place north or south of an equator. Suppose I say Mumbai is 19 degrees north. This means Mumbai is 19 degrees north of the equator. If a line have to be drawn from Mumbai on the globe to the center of the globe, then the line would made an angle of 19 degrees with the horizontal. Another angle of a 19 degree can be measured in south of the equator. So there are two 19 degrees in the south and 19 degrees in the north. So it must be clearly mentioned when I say 19 degrees Mumbai is at 19 degrees north. The line of latitude when drawn through Mumbai parallel to the equator. This parallels of latitude is 19 degree north latitude. Any place or point on this parallel of lines form an any line in 19 degrees at the center. Every parallel of the latitude is a circle. So there are 90 parallels of latitudes in the northern hemisphere to the north and the equator. Similarly, there are 90 parallels of latitudes in the southern hemisphere to the south of the equator. Now all the lines of the latitudes are not for practically. If I draw all the lines, the map would appear very crowded. So what are the points to be noted? The first thing is, a latitude is an angular distance of a place north or south of an equator. There are 180 parallels of latitudes. Each parallel of latitude is a circle. All the parallels of latitudes are not of an equal length. If you see, the circle becomes smaller towards the pole. The equator at the 0 degree is the most and important latitude of the largest circle of the latitude on the globe. It divides the Earth into northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Now if you see, the distance between the any two parallels of latitude lines is always 111 kilometers. The North Pole and the South Pole are fixed points and serve basic points reference. Now What is the importance of latitudes? Latitudes are related to the temperature on the surface of the earth. Planet Earth is a spherical in shape, so different parts of the earth receives different amounts of sunlight. Based on that, three important heat zones of the earth are formed. They are torrid zone, temperate zone and frigid zone. The torrid zone or the tropical zones lies between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Tropic of Cancer is at 23.5 degree north and Tropic of Capricorn is at 23.5 degree south. Now, what is the importance of this torrid zone? Torrid zone receives nearly vertical rays of the sun throughout the year and it receives vertical rays of the sun 2 times in a year. We will understand this better when we learn about the revolution of the earth. Similarly, next one is the temperate zone. The temperate zone lies between the Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle in the north and Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctica Circle in the south. These regions receive slanting rays of the sun, so they never receive vertical rays of the sun. Next one is the frigid zone. Frigid zone in the northern hemisphere lies beyond the Arctic Circle and in the southern hemisphere near the Antarctic Circle near south. The rays of the sun in these regions are slanting, very cold throughout the year. Now in the tropical region, summers are very hot and winters are very cold. Similarly, in the temperate regions, like in India, Delhi lies in the temperate regions. So in the temperate regions, summers are as well as winter both are extreme. And in the frigid zone, throughout the year, it is very cold and cool. After latitudes, we learn about longitudes. Now, just as the latitudes, you can see the earth, the divide the earth into 2 heat zones. Longitudes divides earth into times. What are longitudes? Longitudes is the angular distance of a place east and west of a prime meridian. Now, what is prime meridian? Prime meridian is a longitude that passes through Greenwich near London. All other lines running from North Pole to South Pole are called meridians of longitudes. Now, these are semicircular lines and 2 opposite longitudes together will form 1 big circle. Totally, there are 360 meridians of longitudes. All meridians of equal length and at the distance between any 2 meridians is not equal. Actually they get very close near to the equator. If you see from South Pole and North Pole, there is a relation between longitude and time. As the earth rotates, every place has its sunrise, sunset and noon. Now the earth completes 1 rotation in approximately 24 hours. That means the earth rotates 360 degrees in 24 hours. Or I can say the earth travels an angular distance of 360 degrees in 24 hours. So in 1 hour, how much it will calculate? It is 360 degree divided by 24. So it will be 15. That means the earth rotates 15 degrees in 1 hour. Now if I take India, the longitudinal extent of India is approximately 30 degree longitudes. So suppose I take easternmost end of India, if you see Arunachal Pradesh, there is a sunrise, then I can say the time is 6 o'clock based on the sunrise. After 2 hours, on the other end, on the western side of the India, the people we see sunrise. Because the longitudinal extent of India is 30 degrees. And we have seen the earth travels 15 degrees in 1 hour. So for 30 degrees, it's going to be 2 hours. So I can say that in terms of local time, there will be a difference of 2 hours. And we in India don't go by local time. So we have a standard time. And a standard time of meridian time is 82.5 degree. Now, if the entire country follows local time, it will be different at different places. And this would be lead to confusion. So we have a standard time and also a standard meridian. And a standard meridian is 82.5 degree east, passing through Allahabad. In this way, all countries have their standard time. Many countries, they are big in size, so they have multiple standard of times. So now, different countries have different standard of times. Again, this would cause a big confusion. So, in order to maintain international uniformity, one uniformity of time correspondence to the prime meridian is adopted by all countries. And this is called Greenwich Mean Time or GMT. Now, from GMT, Indian IST added as 82.5 degree, that means there will be a time difference of 5.5 hours. Because if we travel 15 degrees, time difference is 1 hour, 30 degrees, 2 hours, 60 degrees, 4 hours, and 75 degrees, 5 hours. 82.5 degree, that is adding 7.5 hours. So, the time difference will be 5.5 hours. So, if it is 12 noon at prime meridian, in India, the time would be 5:30 p.m. Thank you. I hope you all understood this lesson. Thank you.